Millionaire Rory McCarthy, chairman of Lindstrom's Balloon Company. A life-size action man with a range of interchangeable hairstyles, Rory had followed in the footsteps of Joe Kittinger, breaking two world altitude records for hang gliding and civilian skydiving, both from balloons piloted by Per Lindstrom.
Third person. This project had to be a contributor, had to bring something to the project. It's not just about money and sponsorship, it's about safety. And I have the parachuting altitude record. I've skydived from the altitudes that we're going to. I love speed, velocity. I love power, and in a physical sense. I'm a pilot. I fight fighter jets. I have one that goes faster than the speed of sound and one that goes close to it. Not particularly the most de-stressing of sports and hobbies.
I've got a great personality and, you know, and a contribution towards the cost of the project.
If I am one of the first three men, one of the team that goes around the world first, nobody will ever be able to take that away from us. I suppose the most cataclysmic thing that could happen would be a failure in the structure of the balloon itself. Then we'd have a real problem, and then we would be faced undoubtedly with having to skydive out of the capsule. Now, skydiving out at 35,000 feet is fraught with risk. The temperature at that altitude is in the region of minus 70. Throw in the fact that when we skydive it out, we'll very quickly attain speeds in excess of 300 miles an hour. An early deployment at those altitudes would overstress the parachute to an unbelievable level and would undoubtedly cause a parachute to shred, explode, literally. The only debate would be, what would shred first, the people attached to the parachutes or the parachute itself? So, it's not a walk in the park. And I think that's why I'm here. I mean, I can take Richard with me. I know I can. My six-year-old son, Cameron, who I particularly adore, is at an age where he fully understands what I'm doing, the risks involved. The phone rang, and it was him sort of crying hysterically down the phone, and I found that quite moving, actually. He was actually saying, "Don't go, Daddy." I've talked about it with my wife, Sally, you know, all through last night. And it sort of came to the point where I just said, "Let's just go."
History does not record Sally's reply.